Good afternoon. I'm Colonel Mykola Pidhorodetskyi, and I'm a representative from National Defense University of Ukraine. And dear ladies and gentlemen, participants of the Congress, today I would like to provide you information about steps to increasing the resilience of critical infrastructure by Ukraine. Unfortunately, the threats which appeared due to Russian full-scale invasion in Ukraine is very huge, but I will try to present information very briefly. Since the very beginning of the invasion in Ukraine, Russia uses its missile arsenal to cause maximum damage, destroying over the 700 critical infrastructure facilities to cause so far. Energy infrastructure has been the main target. 40% of it has been damaged and temporarily off. 10% was completely destroyed. And the remaining infrastructure operates only on 50% power. Now, unfortunately, it is impossible to give comprehensive assessment of the level of damage of all objects around Ukraine due to the ongoing Russian aggression. The enemy's means of air attack have changed significantly since the days when the most infrastructure facilities in our country were designed and built. Obviously, therefore, these objects were not ready for modern threats. The Central Military Scientific Department of the General Staff of the Armed Forces of Ukraine acted as the initiator of the main developer of the concept, the country fortress. Country fortress is a concept based on the principle of integral protection of the state in condition of military threats. Experts from various institutions of our country and partner countries participated in the development of the main provision of this concept. On this basis of threats analysis, engineering solutions were proposed for the protection of objects in condition of limited resources. Since we cannot protect all objects at once, there are three of protection have been proposed. Three levels of protection have been proposed. On slide, for your attention, the main properties of the first level of protection. We apply it to an existing object. In Mayer, the first level has to protect against fragments and a blast wave in case of indirect heat at a distance of 15 meters from the missile and indirect heat of Shahed 136 UAVs. We also apply the second level of protection to existing objects. Unlike the first level, it must protect against direct hits of the UAVs of the Shahed types. It works on the principle of a double shell. First one, the pre-detonation screen stops and destroys the UAVs or causes the warhead charge to explode. The second one catches fragments and protects against the blast wave. On this slide, you can see an example of engineer protection plan scheme for a typical critical infrastructure facility. It is not an easy task to protect an object with this huge size of several square kilometers, especially building of the machine room, which is larger than 5 football fields in area. The third level we use for new object and of protection includes reinforced concrete shell, distribution layer, and backfill. The skeleton of the protective structure and the elements of the object that are protected. Current issues and further tasks of engineering protection are highlighted on the slide. I want to draw attention to some of them. First of all, it is necessary to change the places of installations of new equipment instead of the damaged one. Corner reflectors, special smoke screens, and other means of making masking and misleading the targeting system of the enemy's weapon should be used more widely. I would like to take the opportunity to thank you on behalf of the Ukrainian people for your support of our state, for the step you are taking to ensure security for the civilian population. Thank you so much, and be sure that we will win. Thank you so much. Slava Ukraini!
Слава! Дякую вам дуже.